All right, Grandfather. What was so urgent that you couldn't wait until morning to see us? Have Alan and Monica slit each other's throats? Has AJ blown up the foundation? Which family member is facing a crisis now?
You are, Ned.
Me.
How so?
Read this while I have a word with your wife.
Oh, what are you up to now, Mr. Q?
I'm saving your marriage.
Beg pardon?
What does this Japanese pharmaceutical company have to do with me and my marriage?
I see I have your attention.
The answer's no.
What was the question?
Of all the underhanded, sneaky, manipulative things you've ever done, Grandfather, this takes the cake.
What did he do now?
I cavil at underhanded and sneaky. I presented this to you in front of your wife.
Presented what?
You knew exactly how I'd react. Any fool could look at that report and realize that this is a deal that could position ELQ as a major player in the Asian markets well into the 21st century.
All it would require would be 6 months in Tokyo.
Oh, who's going to Tokyo?
Not me. Not now. No way.
Well, you could take Lois with you.
What?
What about L&B? For that matter, what about the idle rich? Lois is putting together a major promotional push for the group.
That can wait. This can't.
Hold it! I am just starting to catch up with you. Shame on you, Mr. Q, pulling a number like this when you and I had a deal.
What deal?
You get Ned from 9 to 5, and I get him nights and weekends, remember?
If you went to Tokyo with him, you'd have him much more than that, but you stand in his way, and you may end up with diddly squat.
How do you figure that?
Don't tell me you haven't noticed that our boy here is getting a trifle restless.
Restless?
What? Excuse
me, I'm sorry. I was just looking for Monica.
I think she went to bed. What in the heaven's name are you two wearing?
It's Halloween, Edward.
We didn't mean to bother you. I just thought I should tell someone I was back to the party.
Oh. Okay. You know, it's a school night, so I'm going to take off.
Yeah. Thanks for bringing me home, Lucky. I had fun.
Yeah, me too. Well, good night.
Good night.
Oh, you too. You look adorable, by the way.
Now, what was that about me being restless, Grandfather?
Oh, that is such baloney. He keeps telling me he's never been happier in his entire life.
Exactly.
Guess I'll turn
in. That's when the trouble always starts. Right, Ned?
Get specific here. What trouble, Mr. Q?
Think back. When you first met Ned, what was he doing? What CEO of a major company would insist on taking field trips under assumed identities in order to investigate a rival hotel chain? And what possessed him to carry that double identity to the ridiculous extreme of becoming a rock and roll idol?
Ridiculous to you, but that's ancient history. My double life is out in the open and running smoothly. Thank you.
I'll bet your inheritance that you missed the Sturm und Drang, huh? There's nothing you like better than life on the edge. Witness marrying two women at the same time. Ho, ho, ho! That gave your adrenaline a real jolt, I'll bet.
What's your point, Mr. Q?
Life has become too tame for our boy. That's my point. He's happily married. ELQ hasn't had a major crisis in months. And why do you think Ned became positively gleeful when AJ made such a botch of things down at the foundation, huh? Because it gave him something to tackle. He is bored. And when he's bored, he makes trouble.
You bored?
I am not bored.
Is that why you want to tinker with the idle rich? Because things are getting too comfortable, too predictable for you?
Proof positive.
Don't let Grandfather do this to you. He is hot for this deal, and now he wants us to uproot our lives to gratify his whims.
It really would be in your best interest to encourage this Tokyo sojourn.
My wife happens to be an executive of her own. She can't just drop everything and take off to Tokyo. And I am not about to leave her or you in control of ELQ or put my ambitions for the idle rich on hold either.
If you pass up this deal, I guarantee you you'll regret it in a month. And he'll take it out on you, honey, one way or another. He is stagnating. And sooner or later, he's going to start to shake things up. Oh, I'm not meaning gyrating his torso in all that black leather. You want to keep him happy, and by extension, keep your marriage on an even keel. You better talk him into this.
You can't get me out of the way that easily, Grandfather. Mark my words, he needs a change.
6 months in Tokyo is the answer.
Get back here. You cannot malign my character in front of my wife and walk away.
I have to. It's time for Annabelle's nightly constitutional.
Goodbye.
Don't play into Grandfather's hand.
He's angling to control us both, and Ellen B. to boot.
I don't control easily. Look me in the eyes, Nedley, huh? Come here. And tell me, are you bored?
I'm not bored.
He's right, you are bored.
Great, great. You believe him and not me.
No, I believe that you do not want to admit that you're bored, not even to yourself. And because you love me, you think that you don't want to rock the boat, but you really do.
You're starting to sound more and more like a Quartermain every day, and that worries me.
Do you remember that we promised each other we would never get too far from Buffalo?
Tokyo is even farther from Buffalo. Check a map.
No, maybe. Maybe, maybe not. Look, I think you're looking for something to shake things up. That's why you came up with this scheme to oust Sonny and why you went after AJ and why you want to change things with the band.
Change is healthy. And don't even get me started on AJ. He should never have been handed the foundation in the first place. And as for Sonny, well, we all agreed to get him out of L&B by any means necessary.
I know that.
So why do you suddenly see this as my idea of fun and games?
There's nothing fun about it. Maybe that's the problem. We're taking everything too seriously, and we're losing sight of all the fun.
The Isle of Rich is fun. Japanese pharmaceutical deals are not fun. You know what we need? We need 4 days in the Bahamas.
That's just a band-aid. It's not a solution.
Well, life can't just be one long yuck. And besides, I'd rather read the phone book by your side than climb the Himalayas with anybody else.
Is that what our marriage has turned into in just a few short months? It's like reading the phone book?
No, of course not.
Do you know how your eyes lit up the first time you looked at that Japanese report?
Lois, it's a great deal. But we have an excellent man in Tokyo who can handle it. I can oversee the entire operation with a couple week-long trips. The key to successful management is knowing how to delegate responsibility.
And what if your grandfather's right?
Lois, it's the old game. He wants Eddie Main out of the picture. He's just getting craftier about it.
Yeah, but wait, what if he knows you better than you know yourself?
I'm not bored. I'm not unhappy. I'm not restless. Okay?
So why am I paranoid?
I think it's separation anxiety. You pushed Miguel out of the nest. Your old friend Sonny has done a number on you. Brenda is not exactly present these days, and you're just waiting for the other shoe to drop.
Maybe.
But hey, our partnership is solid as they come. So don't let Grandfather or anybody else start you doubting us. We've come through a hell of a lot. Personally, I think we've earned a little stability. Now give me a kiss. Come on, give me a kiss. Father coming back for more.
Oh. Yeah?
Hi, it's me.
Hi. Hey.
Sorry.
Come on
Brenda.
In. A little late. What's up? What's happened?
Stone has maybe 6 weeks. He checked out of the hospital tonight. I just came from there.
I don't understand. He seemed to be doing so well.
He has something called, lymphoma. They can treat it with massive chemo and radiation, but it wouldn't buy him much time. And, you know, he'd just be miserable. So I think he just wants to make the most out of the time he has left. And, go out with as much dignity as possible. Sonny's really devastated.
Where did you see Sonny?
I saw Sonny at the hospital. This all just happened tonight. You know how Sonny's trying to deal with this, and you know how he needs to, like, take charge of situations and keep himself busy. He's trying to make all the arrangements for Stone to be taken care of at home. My heart went out to Sonny. I mean, I couldn't really help it. I just don't know what's going to happen to him once there's nothing he can do anymore. I mean, Sonny needs to scream, you know? He needs to let go, and he needs to cry. Lily showed up at the hospital.
Well, you know, we're all gonna do our own share of crying. Stone is... it's gonna be missed.
Admittedly, if Sonny has a saving grace, it's the compassion he's showing that kid. But I'm a little worried about the compassion you're showing Sonny.
Well, don't. Even if I wanted to comfort Sonny, Lily made it very clear that she plans on doing that herself.
Well, you know, maybe we could just comfort each other.